All right, guys. We totally forgot that we needed to run the game. We had to run OBS as administrator in order to run the game. So I'm sorry about that. We will continue. So, without further ado, let's get this show on the road. Alright, so that was a random fight there. I thought that guy was dead, but I guess I was wrong. Though he gave us a bunch of cotton, so I guess we got some use out of him. Alrighty, here we go. Going for these shards!
Thank you. Nothing to report, sir.
So we decided to try somewhere new that I wasn't getting a description on. This may be the ball or something. I don't know. I don't think I've been here. Because Fallow Mirror was where we got our ass whooped by those two undead. So we switched.
Come to join us at the Oasis? It's actually quite the sight. It and the temple are further in.
Anything else I should know?
Not much to tell. A mining company out of Valfremain used to have an interest here, but economies changed and they moved on. Strange the miners never marked the temple on their maps.
So miners did not mark the temple on their maps. I wonder what could be here.
Word for you.
What is it?
someone else here.
Who are you? Why are you following me? I'm just looking for stuff to salvage. I used to work here. I know someone needs this.
I'm with the Inquisition.
Been out here a while. But I'll assume that's important. Doesn't explain why you're following me.
You came all the way out here to salvage old mining equipment.
Mostly, I wanted to go into this one cave. Used to store stuff there. Damn thing wasn't overrun by spiders then. I put my wedding ring there. Couldn't stand the sight of the thing. But I couldn't throw it away either. Oh, it was a stupid argument. Part of me knew I'd still want that ring.
I'll leave you be.
Right. Right. See you then.
You fight hard, Seeker.
We would be dead if I did not.
We are attempting to upgrade our potions, and then after that,
right,
we are going to go to Val Royal, whatever, the ball or some crap.
Flissa said to check with you to make sure these are safe to serve.
They're fine. Nobody will take sick as long as she boils them right. Smart woman for asking, though.
Child is a blessing upon his parents and onto the Maker.
Sigrid says it will cost at least 10.
Fine.
Not sure why you would want to pay out of your own pocket.
Nothing to do with fairness. We simply can't accommodate them if they bring that many servants.
I will speak to the Duchess. She can be reasoned with. Having the Herald address the clerics is not a terrible idea.
You can't be serious.
Mother Giselle isn't wrong. At the moment, the Chantry's only strength is that they are united in opinion.
And we should ignore the danger to the Herald.
Let's ask her.
What can they do? It's just talk.
Don't underestimate the power of their words. An angry mob will do you in just as quickly as a blade.
I will go with her. Mother Giselle said she could provide us names. Use them.
But why? This is nothing but a...
What choice do we have, Liliana? Right now we can't approach anyone for help with the breach. Use what influence we have to call the clerics together. Once they are ready, we will see this through. The city still mourns.
Just a guess, Seeker, but I think they all know who we are.
Your skills of observation never fail to impress me, Varric.
My Lady Herald!
You're one of Leliana's people. What have you found?
The Chantry Mothers await you, but so do a great many Templars.
There are Templars here?
People seem to think the Templars will protect them from the Inquisition. They're gathering on the other side of the market. I think that's where the Templars intend to meet you.
Only one thing to do, then. They wish to protect the people. From us?
You think the Order's returned to the fold, maybe? To deal with us upstarts?
I know Lord Seeker Lucius. I can't imagine him coming to the Chantry's defense. Not after all that's occurred.
We're doing all this to get help with the breach. Maybe this is our chance to get the Templars on our side.
Perhaps. Return to Haven. Someone will need to inform them if we are delayed.
As you say, my lady.
Not open today. Not until this fast is over, at least. Too many swords out.
People of Val Royo, hear me. Together, we mourn our divine. A naive and beautiful heart silenced by treachery. You wonder what will become of her murderer. Well, wonder no more. Behold, the so-called Herald of Andraste, claiming to rise where our beloved fell. We say this is a false prophet, no servant of anything beyond her selfish greed.
You say I am the enemy. The breach in the sky is our true enemy. We must unite to stop it. It's true. The Inquisition seeks only to end this madness before it is too late.
It is already too late. The Templars have returned to the Chantry. They will face this Inquisition and the people will be safe once more. Oh!
Still yourself. She is beneath us.
Was that display supposed to impress me?
On the contrary, it wasn't for you at all.
Lord Seeker Lucius, it's imperative that we speak with...
You will not address me.
Lord Seeker?
Creating a heretical movement, raising up a puppet as Andraste's prophet, you should be ashamed. You should all be ashamed. The Templars failed no one when they left the Chantry to purge the mages. You are the ones who have failed. You who'd leash our righteous swords with doubt and fear. If you came to appeal to the Chantry, you are too late. The only destiny here that demands respect is mine.
What we truly need is an alliance that will seal the breach.
Oh, the breach is indeed a threat. But you certainly have no power to do anything about it.
But Lord Seeker, what if she really was sent by the Maker? What if...
You are called to a higher purpose. Do not question.
I will make the Templar Order a power that stands alone against the Void. We deserve recognition. Independence. You have shown me nothing, and the Inquisition less than nothing. Templars, Val Royo is unworthy of our protection. We march.
Charming fellow, isn't he?
Has Lord Seeker Lucius gone mad?
Do you know him very well?
He took over the Seekers of Truth 2 years ago, after Lord Seeker Lambert's death. He was always a decent man, never given to ambition and grandstanding. This is very bizarre.
Fortunately, the Templars aren't our only hope.
I wouldn't write them off so quickly. There must be those in the Order who see what he's become. Either way, we should first return to Haven and inform the others.
Excuse me, but is what they're saying real? The Inquisition's going to fix the hole in the sky?
That's what we're attempting, yes.
No one is doing anything. Chantry is useless, and the Templars, Andraste. I never thought they'd abandon us. Listen, your camp will need food. I have contacts. We'll have deliveries there in days.
You want to help the Inquisition?
Never been part of something this big before, but if your Inquisition's going to seal the sky, I want to help.
What do you think, Cassandra?
I think the woman is asking you and not me.
Well, she is.
The Herald of Andraste. Yes, I understand. Haven is a mess, but we won't turn away anyone willing to help. Invite her, if it pleases you.
Head to Haven, then. We need good people.
I don't know if I'm that, but it will be nice to see. Thank you.
An arrow with a message?
Ever since our divine was murdered, toothless old fools are lost without her. What are the grand clerics doing while the mage circles lie empty?
It seems change is on the wind. I wish your leaders well.
Maker, know my heart. Take from me a life of sorrow. Comfort is only yours to give. Oh, Maker, where is the comfort? Look away. I have broken the chant because it comes from my heart. What have we when our divine is dead and the sky burns?
The blessings of Andraste are not lost to us. They've been made flesh.
Hold your tongue. I will not hear the blasphemy of a fool who claims to be sent by our holy bride. Maker, put out my eyes. I would rather blindness to this growing dark.
The Templars didn't even touch you.
I believe that messenger is trying to get our attention.
You are the Herald of Andraste, are you not? I have an invitation for you.
I am open to you and yours. I price at a premium for everyone, so don't assume it's because you're with the Inquisition. I expect my customers to know a rarity when they see it, just as I do. I am open to you and yours. I price at a premium for everyone. Expect my customers to know a rarity when they see it, just as I do.
Well, this has all been a frustrating mess. Templars and Chantry and especially the mages. Just everything. I apologize if you were refused service, but we are now open for business. Especially if you put my words to use.
This cannot stand. How can it stand?
Templars left us to the mages. Chantry liars.
This victory must please you greatly, Seeker Cassandra.
We came here seeking only to speak with the mothers. This is not our doing, but yours.
And you had no part in forcing our hand? Do not delude yourself. Now we have been shown up by our own Templars. In front of everyone. And my fellow clerics have scattered to the wind along with their convictions. Just tell me one thing. Do you truly believe you are the Maker's chosen?
To tell you the truth, I don't know.
That is more comforting than you might imagine. I suppose it is out of our hands now. We shall all see what the Maker plans in the days to come.
How many Templars turned on the Chantry exactly?
They rebelled across Thedas. Some remained loyal, but not enough to call them the Order. The White Spire here in the capital was the largest garrison, but now it stands empty. Perhaps more shall flock to the Lord Seeker's banner now. How far has faith waned, I wonder?
You're obviously skeptical. What do you believe I am?
Our Divine. Her Holiness is dead. I have seen evidence for everything. Except, what would comfort me?
That doesn't answer my question.
For you to be true, a great many things must be false. And if you are false, a great many things must have failed. There is chaos ahead, whatever your intentions.
Where is the Lord Seeker taking the Templars?
I can't begin to guess the Lord Seeker's mind. He could not have abandoned his intended role more completely.
There must be sense to what we can't see.
Must there? Rebellion seems popular in certain quarters, doesn't it, Seeker? Is crafting the Templars into a new power really any worse than declaring a rival to the Chantry itself?
So what happens now? Will the Chantry continue to denounce me?
We have already done so. And what good has it done us? Now it falls on us to select a new divine, if we can, and leave the next step to her.
Provided such a selection is even possible.
I truly don't know. Any revered mother who could have followed Justinia died at the Conclave. What becomes of us, and your Inquisition, is in the Maker's hands now.
It's not too late. The Chantry could still help us and come out on top.
If only that were true.
What's to stop you from trying?
We are not looking for a winning horse. We are simply trying to do the right thing. Leave me be, Survivor. Your presence here is not comforting.
There's got to be a way to calm everything down and clean up this mess.
I hope against hope that may be the case.
Our Templars left. The Chantry promised they'd defend us.
We should search the area. Bullshit.
If I might have a moment of your time.
Grand Enchanter Fiona?
Leader of the Mage Rebellion. Is it not dangerous for you to be here?
I heard of this gathering, and I wanted to see the fabled Herald of Andraste with my own eyes. If it's help with the breach you seek, perhaps my people are the wiser option.
The mages weren't willing to talk to the Inquisition before. Why now?
Because now I've seen what you are. And I've seen the Chantry for what it is. Consider this an invitation to Redcliffe. Come, meet with the mages. An alliance could help us both, after all. I hope to see you there.
Au revoir, my Lady Herald.
Come, let us return to Haven.
With passionate breath, does the darkness creep? It is the whisper in the night, the lie.
Well, it seems.
Of course.
Believe this.
What? Yes, I'm sorry. Minding the duties of the ailing mother, Havara. I am rather overwhelmed. Forgive me. I am unsure whether I meant to extend chantry services to you, and that troubles me greatly. Though you had granted them power over the very Fade itself, though they sang hymns of praise unending, though they could do anything, they destroyed nothing.
You have
created nothing. Loved nothing.
Inquisition, eh? I'll sell. But if the Chantry censures you, I'm not liable. No offense, but I have to live here, and Val Royeaux can be traditional. Inquisition, eh? I'll sell. But if the
No offense, but I have to live here, and Val Royeau can be traditional.
These truths the Maker has revealed to me. As there is but one God, one life, one death, there is but one God in our Maker.
The lie upon your sleep.
Open? Yes, as open as I can be. At the very least, we can appear.
They wish to protect the people from us?
We knew there would be some kind of reaction.
But I didn't expect the Templars to make an appearance.
The people may just be assuming what the Templars will do. I've heard of no concrete plans.
You think the Order's returned to the fold, maybe? To deal with us upstarts?
I know Lord Seeker Lucius. I can't imagine him coming to the Chantry's defense. Not after all that's occurred.
So the potential for trouble has increased twofold.
Perhaps. Return to Haven. Someone will need to inform them if we are delayed.
As you say, my lady.
So, we are gonna check out with the mages, see what's going on in their books.
Lady Trevelyan of Ostwick,
representing the Inquisition.
What a pleasure to meet you, my lady. Seeing the same faces at every event becomes so tiresome. So you must be a guest of Madame de Fer. Or are you here for Duke Bastien?
Are you here on business? I have heard the most curious tales of you. I cannot imagine half of them are true.
I'm not familiar with that name. I was invited here by First Enchanter Vivienne.
Madame de Fer is a fond nickname the court has given Lady Vivienne.
I've heard she finds it amusing.
I've heard very little about Duke Bastien.
He hasn't been seen much at court lately.
His business with the Council of Heralds often takes him from home for long periods. It can't be good for a man of his years.
And, of course, there's the civil war. Bastien probably wishes to distance himself from the actions of his one-time son-in-law.
Tearing up the Dales in a foolish bid for power? It will end in disgrace for Gaspar. Everyone knows it.
What have you heard about me?
Some say that when the veil opened, Andraste herself delivered you from the Fade.
Some of those storytellers may have gotten carried away.
But only for the best effect. The Inquisition is a ripe subject for wild tales.
The Inquisition. What a lot of pig shit. Washed up sisters and crazed seekers. No one can take them seriously. Everyone knows it's just an excuse for a bunch of political outcasts to grab power.
The Inquisition is working to restore peace and order to Thedas.
Here comes the outsider, restoring peace with an army. We know what your Inquisition truly is. If you were a woman of honor, you'd step outside and answer the charges.
My dear Marquis, how unkind of you to use such language in my house to my guests. You know such rudeness is intolerable.
Madame Vivienne, I humbly beg your pardon.
You should. Whatever am I going to do with you, my dear? My lady, you're the wounded party in this unfortunate affair. What would you have me do with this foolish, foolish man?
I think the Marquis has seen the error of his ways.
By the grace of Andraste, you have your life, my dear. Do be more careful with it. I'm delighted you could attend this little gathering. I've so wanted to meet you. Allow me to introduce myself. I am Vivienne, First Enchanter of Montsimard and Enchantress to the Imperial Court.
Charmed, Lady Vivienne.
Ah, but I didn't invite you to the chateau for pleasantries. With Divine Justinia dead, the Chantry's in shambles. Only the Inquisition might restore sanity and order to our frightened people. As the leader of the last loyal mages of Thedas, I feel it only right that I lend my assistance to your cause.
What exactly can you do for the Inquisition?
I am well versed in the politics of the Orlesian Empire. I know every member of the Imperial Court personally. I have all the resources remaining to the Circle at my disposal. And I'm a mage of no small talent. Will that do?
Is your interest in the Inquisition Madame de Fer, or is it more personal?
Aren't you charming? It's professional, of course.
You say you led the last of the loyal mages. Loyal to whom?
To the people of Thedas, of course. We have not forgotten the commandment, as some have, that magic exists to serve man. I support any effort to restore such order.
The Inquisition will be happy to have you, Lady Vivian.
Great things are beginning, my dear. I can promise you that.
Go in peace, Herald of Andraste.
It's good you've returned. We heard of your encounter.
You heard?
My agents in a city sent word ahead, of course.
It's a shame the Templars have abandoned their senses, as well as the capital.
At least we know how to approach the mages and Templars now.
Do we? Lord Seeker Lucius is not the man I remember.
True, he has taken the order somewhere, but to do what? My reports have been very odd.
We must look into it. I'm certain not everyone in the Order will support the Lord Seeker.
Or the Herald could simply go to meet the mages in Redcliffe instead.
You think the Mage Rebellion is more united? It could be 10 times worse.
I could at least find out what the mages want.
No doubt what they've always wanted. Support for their cause.
We shouldn't discount Redcliffe. The mages may be worth the risk.
They are powerful, Ambassador, but more desperate than you realize.
After the Divine's death, they're probably scrambling for allies.
If some among the rebel mages were responsible for what happened at the Conclave,
the same could be said about the Templars.
True enough. Right now, I'm not certain we have enough influence to approach the Order safely.
Then the Inquisition needs agents in more places. That's something you can help with.
In the meantime, we should consider other options. There is one other matter. Several months ago, the Grey Wardens of Ferelden vanished. I sent word to those in Orlais, but they have also disappeared. Ordinarily, I wouldn't even consider the idea they're involved in all this, but the timing is curious.
That does sound odd. I agree.
The others have disregarded my suspicion, but I cannot ignore it. 2 days ago, my agents in the Hinterlands heard news of a Grey Warden by the name of Blackwall. If you have the opportunity, please seek him out. Perhaps he can put my mind at ease.
And if he can't?
Then there may be more going on than we thought.
Got a message for the Inquisition, but I'm having a hard time getting anyone to talk to me.
Who are you, soldier?
Chromisius Aclasi with the Bull's Charges Mercenary Company. We mostly work out of Orle and Navara. We've got word of some Tevinter mercenaries gathering out on the Storm Coast. My company commander, Iron Bull, offers the information free of charge. If you'd like to see what the Bull's Charges can do for the Inquisition, meet us there and watch us work.
What should I know about your commander?
Einbull. He's one of those Qunari, the big guys with the horns. He leads from the front, he pays well, and he's a lot smarter than the last bastard I work for. Best of all, he's professional. We accept contracts with whoever makes the first real offer. You're the first time he's gone out of his way to pick a side.
I look forward to meeting this Einbull.
We're the best you'll find. Come to the Storm Coast and you can see us in action.
I heard the Templars have withdrawn.
Seems odd.
Blessed are the peacekeepers, the champions of the just. Blessed are the righteous, the lights in the shadow. In their blood, the Maker's will is written. Is that what you want from us? Blood? To die so that your will is done? Is death your only blessing?
You speak for Andraste, no? What does the Maker's prophet have to say about all of this? What's his game?
I speak for no one but myself, and I have no answers for you.
Then we can only guess at what he wants. The Chantry teaches that the Maker abandoned us. He demands repentance for our sins. He demands it all. Our lives, our deaths. Justinia gave him everything she had, and he let her die.
I'm sorry. Her death has clearly hit you hard.
Not just me. All of us. She was the divine. She led the faithful. She was the heart. If the Maker doesn't intervene to save the best of his servants, what good is he? I used to believe I was chosen, just as some say you are. I thought I was fulfilling his purpose for me. Working with the divine, helping people. But now she's dead. It was all for nothing. Serving the Maker meant nothing.
Maybe you have another purpose. I could help you find it.
No, this is my burden. I regret that I even let you see me like this. It was a moment of weakness. It won't happen again. Come, to work then. We will speak later.
I met an elven mage earlier. Solus, I believe he was called. I admit I was surprised. I didn't expect to find mages among the Inquisition. Tell me, why were you at the Divine Conclave?
The war benefits no one. It must end, and order must be restored.
If only the rebels saw things so clearly. Justinia's death has shattered the balance of power in Thedas. If it is not restored quickly, countless lives will be lost. Mages, Templars, innocent people of all kinds now look to the Inquisition to decide their fate.
I'll try not to let them down.
Failure is a luxury we cannot afford, my dear. For almost 1,000 years, the world believed it was in the hands of the Maker. And now many believe you are the agent of his will. Whatever the truth is, that belief gives you power.
If that's true, then I'll put it to good use.
I suppose we'll see. I've stolen enough of your time, my dear. Don't let me keep you.
I will take these injury reports to research.
The apothecary would like to know why you need so much death row.
To do my job.
Oh, I'll just tell him that.
Hello? Can I help you with something?
I'll speak with you later.
Travel safely.
What may I do for you?
What do the people make of us?
Despite our fame, we're low on steadfast allies. We must aim for more.
Any visiting dignitaries I should watch out for?
Sir Griffith of Denerim, a most distinguished knight of the realm. He's defeated darkspawn, slain demons, chased down abominations. Just don't ask him about it over dinner. He spares no detail.
My creator.
Any word?
Nothing yet.
Alright guys, we are going to pause it real here, right here, and we're going to get ourselves something to eat. Thank you.
Nothing to report, sir.
We do.
5 or 6 wounded, Chief. No dead.
That's what I like to hear. Let the throat cutters finish up, then break out the casks. So, you're with the Inquisition, huh? Glad you can make it. Come on, have a seat. Drinks are coming.
Iron Bull, I presume.
Yeah, the horns usually give it away. I assume you remember Chromisius Eclasi, my lieutenant.
Good to see you again. Rope cutters are done, Chief.
Already? Have them check again. I don't want any of those Tevinter bastards getting away. No offense, Krem.
None taken. At least a bastard knows who his mother was. Puts him one up on you, Canari, right?
So, you've seen us fight. We're expensive, but we're worth it. And I'm sure the Inquisition can afford us.
The Chargers seem like an excellent company.
They are, but you're not just getting the boys. You're getting me. You need a frontline bodyguard. I'm your man. Whatever it is, demons, dragons, the bigger the better. And there's one other thing, might be useful, might piss you off. Ever hear of the Ben Hasra?
They're a Kunari organization, right? The equivalent of their guards and City Watch.
I'd go closer to spies, but yeah, that's them. Or, well, us. The Ben Hasrath are concerned about the breach. Magic out of control like that could cause trouble everywhere. I've been ordered to join the Inquisition, get close to the people in charge, and send reports on what's happening. But I also get reports from Ben Hasrath agents all over Orlais. You sign me on, I'll share them with your people.
Hold on, guys. Gotta get my pizza.
What's in these Ben Hathrath reports you're offering to share?
Enemy movements, suspicious activity, intriguing gossip. It's a bit of everything. Alone, they're not much, but if your spy master is worth a damn, she'll put him to good use.
She?
I did a little research. Plus, I've always had a weakness for redheads.
You're a Kunari spy, and you just told me.
Whatever happened at that conclave thing, it's bad. Someone needs to get that breach closed. So whatever I am, I'm on your side.
You still could have hidden what you are.
From something called the Inquisition? I'd have been tipped sooner or later. Better you hear it right up front from me.
All right, you're in.
Excellent. Prem, tell the men to finish drinking on the road. The Chargers just got hired.
What about the casks, Chief? We just opened them up with axes.
Find some way to seal them. You're Tervinter, right? Try blood magic. We'll meet you back at Haven.
we're going to attempt the rift again, now with Iron Bull in our group. He seems to be a heavy damage dealer, so we'll check his stats and weapons and equipment to see if we have something better for him. Go. We're going to take a minute to eat some food, and then we'll be right back.
You know, the Bin Hasrath are a lot like your Seekers, Cassandra.
I highly doubt that.
Maintaining justice in the ranks, operating under a veil of secrecy, investigating corruption and threats to the Order, and we deal with it all so quietly. Most people never notice.
Interesting. Though we do not break the minds of our prisoners.
We'll keep at it. You guys will get there.
surprising that there are no ships. This time of year, there should be plenty.
Alright guys, we are going to have to go for now, but that is totally fine, because we will be back later on tonight to continue.